It's Britney, bitch.
Show. Let's find out. How do you get an 80-year-old granny to shout cunt? Get another one to shout bingo. If a stork brings a white baby and a blackbird brings a black baby, what brings no babies? A good swallow. A wife gets naked and asks the hubby, what turns you on more, my pretty face or my sexy body? The hubby looks up at her and then down again and replies, your sense of humour. Scientific studies show 99% of men would love to be a tablecloth. It's the only chance in hell they have of getting laid three times a day and pulled off last thing at night. Paddy was shocked to hear that all the cows in his field had got blue tongue. By Jesus, Paddy shouted, I didn't even know they had fucking mobiles. Paddy weighs 20 stone, so his doctor puts him on a diet. I want you to eat regularly for the first 2 days and then skip a day and repeat this for 2 weeks. You should lose 5 pounds. When Paddy returned, he shocked the doctor by having lost 4 stone. That's amazing, the doctor said. Paddy nodded. I'll tell you, be Jesus, I thought I was going to drop dead by the third day. What from? Hunger, the doctor said. No, from fucking skipping. When David Beckham scores, I drink a Bex. When Paul Scholes drinks, I drink a Skull. When Tommy Miller scores, I drink a Miller. Thank fuck David Seaman was a goalie. Jack and Jill went up the hill so Jack could lick Jill's fanny. Jack got a shock and a mouthful of cock caused... Jack and Jill went up the hill so Jack could lick Jill's fanny. Jack got a shock and a mouthful of cock because Jill's a pre-op tranny. Fresh 9-inch penis, tied with Italian bay leaves and marinated in bolognese sauce. Tender testicles brushed with hot melted butter and lightly grilled on maple-soaked skewers. Sweet pierced nipples smeared in hot melted Belgian chocolate and served in steaming toffee custard. This is not just food. This is S&M food. A little girl goes to the barber with her dad. Whilst he is having his hair cut, she stands next to him, eating a cake. You'll get hair all over your muffin, the barber says to her. Yes, I know, says the little girl. I'll get tits too, you dirty bastard. Little Johnny hears noises coming from his parents' bedroom. He He goes in and sees his dad giving his mum one. He stands there and giggles. "Get out," his dad says, and throws a pillow at him. Later, Dad hears a commotion coming from the little Johnny's bedroom. He goes in and sees Johnny giving his gran one. "What do you think you're doing?" he proclaims. Little Johnny replies, "It's not funny when it's your mum, is it?" Paddy says to Mick, "Can you help me with this jigsaw? It's meant to be a tiger." Mick says, "Put the Frosties back in the box, you thick twat." Harley Davidson died and went to heaven, and was boasting to God about how he created the best motorbike in the world. God disagreed, saying BMWs were a better designed bike. Harley said, "What the fuck do you know about design? You created a woman, and look at the problems we have with them." "Ahem," says God, "I think you'll find a lot more men are riding my fucking creation." What did the cannibal do after he dumped his girlfriend? He wiped his bottom. What's the difference between PMT and BSE? One attacks the cow's brains and sends it fucking mental, and apparently the other is an agricultural problem. A tramp walks into a jeweller's and casually begins to finger his own arse. The jeweller screams, "Get out." The tramp points to the sign, "Come in and pick your ring in comfort." A little gypsy girl opens a caravan door and shouts, "Ma'am, how do I put my knickers on again?" Mum replies, "How many more times? Yellow to the front, brown to the back." What's worse than a male chauvinist pig? A woman that doesn't do what she's told. Cure for homosexuality. Lip balm. You rub it on your asshole and it keeps the chaps away. There's a new family car on the market. You put your kids in it, but they don't come back. It's called the Renault Macan. Manchester police are on the lookout for a racist attacker. I phoned the info line, but apparently it's not a job advertisement. "Hi mate, yeah, I need your advice. Some bloke down the pub's offered me 8 venison legs for 50 quid. Is that too dear?"
Hi, you're watching Folk TV number 8 from Corfu. Cheers.
A Chinese man rings his boss. "Me no work, I sick." Boss says, "When I'm sick, I fuck my wife, try that." 2 hours later, the Chinese man rings back. "Me better, you got nice house." St. Peter took Pavarotti to God and said, "Here's that tenner I owe you." Elton John went to a tattooist and said, "I want a Rolls Royce, tattooed on my penis." He said, "You'd be better off with a Land Rover, it won't get stuck in the shit." A fella buys a packet of mixed condoms, raspberry, banana, etc. He says to his other half, "Let's play a game, I'll put one on and you guess the flavour." So they agree. Goes down under the blanket and says, "Cheese and onion." He says, "For fuck's sake, give me a chance to put one on." Congratulations to Madeline McCann, Thomas Cook Kids Club Hide and Seek Champion of 2007.
Day 2 in the big Corfu house. Zoe Howarth is reading a book. It is not the first book she's ever read, and nor is it likely to be the last.
"Hi, I'm sorry, this is just not for me. I'm going to go back to Firk TV. I mean, it was a great offer, but I don't want to star in remakes of horror films that just weren't scary to start with. I mean, who am I? I'm not Paris Hilton, you know."
Hello, thank you very much for watching Firk TV episode number 8 from the gorgeous Greek island of Corfu. This has been Ipsos, a rather simple place, a rather small seaside area, a few shops, and some nice bars and restaurants. If you do come here, go to Three Brothers, have yourself a pint or a cocktail, very well priced, and enjoy yourself in the sun.